Automation is driving changes in many industries. Transportation, education, healthcare, and most other fields are expected to undergo tangible disruption in the near future. One of the technologies behind this development is machine learning. Machine learning describes a family of methods that solve a certain task by learning from experience. One of these methods is neural networks. At the Institute for Cancer Genetics and Informatics, we employ a combination of deep neural networks and mathematical concepts, often called deep learning. Deep refers to the multiple layers in the network. Deep learning is central to the development of automated services, such as driverless cars, digital assistants, object recognition, and automatic translators.
We are home to the moon.
In the DoMore project at ICGI, we use deep learning in cancer research applications. For example, in the automation of delineating and grading tumors. This means identifying malignant tumor areas and determining the prognosis, a major task carried out by the pathologist, the specialized physician who diagnoses cancer. For this demonstration, we will treat the image as a whole. A color digital image is composed of three primary color channels, carrying intensity information in a grayscale format. In the analysis of these images, the computer sorts these pixels into a matrix of numbers. For each pixel, the computer assigns a numerical value from 0 to 1, based on a grayscale where black represents an intensity of 0 and white represents full intensity 1. To extract image features, filters are used. A filter is a matrix of numbers which, when applied to the image matrix, extracts different features. To make this process visible, we have scaled up the pixels. We generate our own filters as part of the training process. These filters have the specific purpose of identifying tumor features. A layer of convolved images is generated by running filters across the grid. Convolutional neural networks consists of many such layers, where each image is extracting different features from the previous layer. We then use local operations to downscale these images to produce a so-called pooling layer. This is done to aggregate the features and reduce dimensionality. A second convolved layer is generated by running a different set of filters over the pooled images. In this case, 16 filters in total. The pattern of convolving and pooling continues until we have generated sufficient feature information. Network configurations can range from just a few to thousands of layers, leading to many millions of trainable parameters. We consolidate the final layers of feature images, which results in values representing the probability of the patient's outcome. The difference between the predicted output and the desired output is measured using a mathematical function, often called a loss function. This calculation provides a point of orientation that guides the necessary adjustments to the filter values. We then use an iterative optimization method to minimize this loss function. It uses a method called backpropagation to compute the values needed to adjust the filter parameters in the network. This is done by sending new images through the neural network and adjusting the initial filters until the output image is approximating the ground truth well enough. This process is called training. Deep learning utilizes massive amounts of labeled data, commonly known as big data. In our case, this means the image of the patient's cancerous tissue along with their follow-up information. For colorectal cancer, we have over 4,000 cases with more than 5 years of follow-up information for the patient group. Data sets of this size with such extensive clinical follow-up are incredibly rare, giving us a unique position when applying deep learning to pathology.